Hello students, welcome to your science class. Today we are going to do chapter 9, cooking and eating habits. This is your activity based chapter. So you will be doing the activity sheet and one of the activities of this chapter. So before we move ahead, let's know the learning outcomes of this chapter. So at the end of this video lesson, you'll be able to, number one, identify the benefits of cooking, recognize the foods that are eaten raw, list the methods of cooking food, and name the utensils used in kitchen. You must have seen your parents cooking tasty food for you in the kitchen, but this was not so few millions of years ago. Millions of years ago on earth, there was early man. An early man lived in caves or huts and hunted animals for food. Like this. And in the early days, there were no means of cooking food. Early man did not know how to cook the food. So he used to eat the food in raw form only. Whether it was fruit or vegetable or whether it was meat, he used to take it in raw form or kacha form only. But when there was discovery of fire, he came to know that the food can be cooked. What happened was, accidentally the food fell in the fire. And when he took out the food from the fire, the food was tasty, that meat was tasty, and it was very soft. So now he learned that he can cook his food because cooking makes the food soft, right? So he learned that the cooking of the food makes it soft and tasty and easily digestible. Digestible means that it is good for your stomach. And cooking has got many benefits, and those are: cooking makes the food soft, tasty, germ-free, and easily digestible, and you can preserve the food for long time. Like it has, the shelf life of the food can be increased by cooking the food. But we do not always cook our food items. Food items like fruits, you can say mango, orange, pineapple, watermelon, grapes, pear, apple, strawberry, banana, and pomegranate. Many of the fruits and vegetables like tomato, beetroot, peas, cucumber, broccoli, carrot, radish, cabbage, onion and chili. These are the fruits and the vegetables which can be eaten raw. Now you can make a list of the fruits and vegetables. Right. And you know, fruits and veggies are good for our health. But remember, we should always wash the fruits and vegetables before eating them raw or before cooking. But too much of cooking can also destroy the nutrients of food, right? See, you can see a burnt toast or a burnt pizza. So if you cook the food for a long time, the nutrients of the food can be destroyed. But if the food is left undercooked, it is not cooked properly, even then it will taste tasteless and it can cause pain in the stomach. These are few of the methods by which the food can be cooked. It can be directly on the flame. You can stir fry, frying, boil, even barbecue, steam, bake, roast, poach, or toaster, steamer. These are few of the methods by which we can cook the food. But in our syllabus, we have got these five methods of cooking the food, and those are boiling, steaming, baking, frying, and direct heating. Remember, boiling and steaming both are done with water. So let's do them turn by turn. First method is boiling. To boil the food, we have to take a large pot of water and then put the food in it. Boil the water and the food will also cook in the heat of the water. When we boil the food, the germs can be killed from that food. एंड यू नो दाल्स और पल्सेस राइट दे आर कुक्ड बाय बॉइलिंग देम इन वॉटर फॉर डिफरेंट पीरियड्स ऑफ टाइम. इट मीन्स दैट पल्सेस लाइक राजमा और चना दे टेक मोर टाइम टू कुक वाइल एज मूंग दाल एक्सेट्रा इट टेक्स लेस टाइम टू कुक. सो डिफरेंट पीरियड्स ऑफ टाइम आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर बॉइलिंग द पल्सेस. एंड टू बॉइल द फूड अ प्रेशर कुकर इज यूज्ड बिकॉज इन प्रेशर कुकर इट इज प्रेशराइज्ड कुकिंग एंड इट टेक्स लेस टाइम टू कुक द फूड. यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड द विसल ऑफ द कुकर इन द किचन. एंड फूड्स लाइक एग्स pasta, noodles are first boiled in water and then spices are added. Now you can make up the list of the foods which are cooked by boiling. Okay. And now milk is also boiled before drinking because boiling of the milk kills the germs and preserves the milk for long time. Coming to next topic, that is steaming. Now, what is steam first of all? When you boil the water, the vapors over the water, those are the steam, right? That thing is called the steam. So, steaming of the food is done by the steam produced by the boiling water. See here, when the water is boiling in this pan, this is the steam. You keep the food in this sieve, okay, and then the food can be cooked in this steam. For this, a deep vessel can be used. And what are the benefits of steaming the food? Well, see, the steaming shortens the duration of cooking. Steamed foods are easy to digest. Steaming helps in conserving the nutrition of food. And also, the color of the food is not destroyed in steaming. And the foods like idli, dhokla, momos, steamed vegetables, are cooked in the steam produced from water. Okay, so now you can list the foods you can cook by steaming. First was boiling, second was steaming. And now third is baking. By baking we mean that baking is done in an oven or a microwave oven, right? Then this is the indirect way of heating the food. And it can be done with oil or without oil. Like you are not putting the food directly on the heat, but around the food there is so much of heat in the oven that the food gets cooked automatically. And the foods like cakes, biscuit breads, puddings, pies and pizzas are made by baking them in an oven. Let's come to the next topic, that is frying. When we fry the food, we fry the food in the hot oil. The food is put in that very, very hot oil and then the food gets cooked in that oil. You know, the foods which are cooked in hot oil are very tasty. And those tasty foods are pakoda, vada, tikki, samosa, jalebi, bread pakoda, puri, kachori and matthi also. And then these foods are cooked in oil. Though they are very tasty, but this is not a very healthy method of cooking food. We should not eat much of the oily food because it is not good for our health. Coming to the next topic, direct heating. Direct means that you are keeping the food directly on the fire. Just like the way early man used to do. So this is the oldest method of cooking. And the foods like chapati, paneer tikka or chicken tikka, tacos, papad, sweet potato, maize are often cooked directly by heating on the fire. Now to cook different types of foods, different types of utensils are used. Your mother must be having a tawa or a fry pan or wok. Wok is to make the noodles. Or a saucepan, pressure cooker, steamer, or stock pot, or pizza tray, whisk, thermos, spatula, knife, fork, spoon, right? And pizza cutter, potato peeler, rolling pin, that is belan, tongs, different types of containers in the kitchen to cook the food. So when your mother is cooking the food, different types of utensils are used in the kitchen. Okay, so with this we end today's chapter, but there is an activity for you, and that is that you have to pen down your favorite dish and write down the method used by you for cooking the food. With this we end today's lesson and chapter 9. Eat healthy, stay healthy, and enjoy your day. Bye bye.